Hi everybody, it's Nadia from Yarn Utopia. Today we're making the Joyful Teapot Cozy. This is so much fun to make and it's so cool. Oh my gosh, I am like a tea obsessed person. Like seriously, team chai, everybody. So this is so much au this is so awesome, you guys. I'm so excited to share this with you and to make this together today. So I'm just gonna get right into the supplies we need. I'll answer some frequently asked questions and then we'll get into making this teapot cozy. So the supplies I'm using, big thank you to Red Heart Yarns for providing the yarn today. This is the main color here is actually Red Heart Boutique Gleam. I only have a little bit left here, but this color is called Creamy. Here's the label I had from it. So it's a new yarn that I've never used before. It's Red Heart Boutique Gleam. I think I might have used these actually in my unicorn slippers. So if you want to check out the unicorn slippers, that's also on yarnutopia.com. These balls of yarn are 169 yards or a 3.5 ounce ball. I used most of it. I only had this much left, so you may want to just get a full skein of that. And then this color, the main color of my teapot cozy is creamy. Okay, this is a size 4 medium worsted weight yarn, so you can use any worsted weight, which is very similar to a double knitting yarn. You can use that as well. That's totally fine if you can't get this specific yarn where you live. Now, the accent colors, I am using also the Red Heart Boutique Gleam for these holly leaves. So this is the same type of yarn. This green color though is called patina. So if you wanted to use the green yarn in this Red Heart Boutique Gleam, you're not going to need a whole lot, probably less than 10 yards of this accent color for the leaves. But I demonstrate this actually making the leaves in a Red Heart Super Saver yarn, which also looks fabulous. So you can view this video and you can see when I share how to make the leaves. I'm actually not using this specific yarn to show you because it is kind of shiny and it's kind of difficult to see the stitches. So I just wanted you to see the stitches. So I'm using a Super Saver yarn to do that instead. And then this red yarn that I'm using for the holly berries and the word joy. I don't have the label for this, but it is called Red Heart Shimmer, and the color is red, obviously. So this is, I don't have the label for it, but it is called Red Heart Shimmer in red, and I will have the link to where you can find it on my website. So check out yarnutopia.com on the post for the Joyful Teapot Cozy, and you will find a link to where you can find this specific yarn. So that's all the yarn we're using. I'm going to demonstrate this with a G6 hook, which is 4.25 millimeters. If you have, whoa, there you go. If you have a 4 millimeter hook, which is just a G hook, or an H hook, which is a 5 millimeter hook, you can totally use that as well if you don't have the 4.25 millimeter. So I'm just gonna use this hook though and demonstrate with that. You're also going to need a scissors and some yarn needles. I'm using a big yarn needle and a small yarn needle to sew in some ends, and those will come in handy when you cut your yarn and sew in your ends because there's a lot of sewing in this, you guys. A lot of sewing, so be prepared. Also, just a little tip for you guys when you're making your word and your holly berries and all the leaves and everything. I used some sewing needles just to pin everything down, or not sewing needles, sorry. Well, I guess they're kind of like sewing needles. These needles, these little pins, sewing pins, I pinned everything down on my cut on my teapot cozy, and then I sewed it on when it all looked good. Also, big thing you should do is put everything on while your teapot cozy is on your teapot, just so when you take it off, it kind of bunches up and it doesn't stretch out. And then if you sewed everything on without it being stretched out and you put it on this, it might turn out to be a little wonky looking. You're also going to need a little button down here. I have a little, just a little plastic button here. You can find buttons really any craft shop. You can use a nice little vintage button or a shiny sparkly button if you're using this sparkly yarn, but we're gonna be using that so that you can button this up just like this. So That's how we're making this piece, actually. We're starting from the top, working our way down, and this is what it looks like. So it just is like this. So there's our teapot cozy, and then you just put it on from like just like this, and there's a teapot spout hole right in the front. And then in the back here, you just have to wrap this around. Okay, make sure it looks all good, and then button it up. So it's that simple, and it looks fabulous. It'll be great to have this, you know, on the dinner table at a family gathering or something. Great for the holidays. So, and it's a great gift idea. If you wanted to get somebody a teapot, why not put a personal touch and put a cozy over the top of it? So, but now some frequently asked questions. So how big is this? Let's answer that. Well, mine is a 4-cup teapot. Okay, 4 cups of a teapot. And the height of it is about 5.5 inches, okay? About 6 inches from going around everything from the bottom to the top, 6 inches here, which is, let's see here, about 15 centimeters, 14 and a half centimeters. So that's how tall this is. And it's a basic pattern though. You're going to be increasing, starting from the top, increasing and then coming down and increasing around the sides. So it is quite versatile actually. We're mainly working with half double crochets. There are puff stitches in here to give it some dimension, but mostly half double crochets in this project. So if you know how to do the increase, you can keep increasing to make it bigger. You can make it longer just by adding more rows between rows 10 and 13. And then also at the bottom, if you need to decrease some more, you can even decrease some more around the bottom. So, and then we're working in rows on each side, and then we're sewing it closed here. So just continue to watch this video tutorial and you'll see step by step how I make this. But before we start, one last thing I want to mention, there are links in the description of this video. So there is a link to the blog, yarnutopia.com, where you'll get the written pattern and the video tutorial will also be on there and all the pictures and everything. And then in the description of this video, there's a link to the Facebook and Instagram. So if you make this or make something similar to this, I mean, you don't have to put the word joy on it. You could put the word tea on it or put another word, peace, love, or something on there. Then, you know, share a photo of what you make. You don't have to use these specific embellishments either. You can embellish this with whatever you want. Make the shell of this, just the plain shell, and then embellish it how you want. Also, you can share a photo on Instagram. Just make sure to hashtag YarnUtopia so I can see your work. You can also tag me in your photos or comment on your own photo at me, you know, at YarnUtopia by Nadia Fouad, so I can see your photo so I can double tap it and comment on it as well. You can Snapchat me. I'm YarnUtopia on Snapchat. And if you see this or want to make this, you can definitely Snapchat me a photo of what's on your hook. So, and lastly, I have to say a big thank you to my dad, Fouad, as much for taking the time to make this video with us. He is our videographer, editor, and photographer for all of our videos. So make sure you hop on over to yarnutopia.com and view all the video tutorials that we have. And yeah, a big thank you to him. So make sure you comment and thank him for all his work and subscribe to our channel here on YouTube. If you could, in the corner of this video, there is an I. It says support Yarnutopia or check out more information here. It's a little I letter in your corner of your video. Make sure you click that. Support Yarnutopia today, so that we can keep bringing you these fantastic crochet tutorials. So now let's get started and make the joyful teapot cozy. All right, let's start out with your main color and make a slip knot. So put your short end over the long end, then fold this down and then pull that long end through and pull tight. Okay, insert your hook into that loop and we can begin. So let's start out by chaining 12. So yarn over and pull through, 1, yarn over, pull through, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. And now what we're going to do, you can see your chain looks like this. We are going to kind of flip this over, okay, like this, and then we're going to go into that first chain right there. Okay, so you can go either into there, right like that, or you can turn this around and you can see this back ridge here, which is what I like to work in. We're gonna go in there, okay? And then what we're going to do is make a slip stitch to form a big ring. So yarn over, pull through, and pull through. Just like that, okay? Now, going on to round number one, we are going to chain up one. And in that same chain that we just slip stitched into, this looks like a stretched out hole there, we're gonna put a single crochet in there. So go in, yarn over, pull through, and then yarn over and pull through two loops. Okay, and we're gonna single crochet into each chain around. So you can see this next chain right here, we're gonna go in, then yarn over, pull through, and then yarn over and pull through two loops. So that's number two going into the next chain. This is number three, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through two. Okay, and we're going to have then 12 single crochets at the end of this round here. Let me just get all the way around on here. And then once you single crochet all the way around, we'll go on to round number two. When you come back around and single crochet around, just make sure you have 12 single crochets in total. These last few spots right here may look like stitches where you have to put your single crochets, but just ignore them. As long as you have 12 single crochets on round one, that is where you need to be. So, and if it does get twisted a little bit, just make sure to twist it to make it straight all the way around, just like this. And then we're gonna go into the first single crochet right here, okay? So not this chain up one. If you need to, count back 12 stitches all the way around and then go into that last one that you count. So right in here. And then we're gonna slip stitch. So yarn over, pull through, and pull through. And that's round one. Now we'll sew this in and that gaping hole right there will be hidden when we sew it in. Okay, but I'll do that later. So now I'm gonna chain up one and go on to round two. We are just going to single crochet into each stitch. So go into this first stitch right here, yarn over, pull through, and then yarn over and pull through two loops. Okay, next stitch right here, go in, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through two loops. So that's two. This next stitch is three. This is four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. Here's 11, and our last one is 12. Okay, now we're going to slip stitch to the first single crochet. So right in here, go in, yarn over, pull through, and pull through. Okay, so now you can see this is the top. This is going to go around that knob on our top of our teapot. And now we're going to be working the side here that's going to cover the lid of our teapot. So we need to increase. So what we're going to do is chain one. And we are going to make something called a puff stitch in this first stitch right here. So we are going to yarn over, go into this very first stitch that we just slip stitched into, yarn over and pull through. Okay, you can kind of pull up just a hair. Then yarn over, go back into that same stitch, and then yarn over and pull through. So now we have five loops on the hook. We're going to yarn over and pull through all five of those loops. Just like that. Okay. Then we're going to chain one to close it. Okay. And we're going to repeat this now. So in the same stitch right here that we worked in, we're going to put another puff stitch. So yarn over, go back into the same stitch, yarn over, pull through, pull up a little bit, yarn over, and go back into that same stitch, yarn over, and pull through. And now we have five loops on the hook. One, two, three, four, five. We're going to yarn over and pull through all five of those loops and then chain one. Now that whole sequence, puff stitch, chain one, puff stitch, chain one, is going to be put in each stitch around. So in this next stitch right here, we're going to put a puff stitch. So yarn over, go into this next stitch, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, go back in, yarn over, pull through, and then yarn over and pull through all 5 of the loops on your hook, and then chain 1 to close it. Now we're going to put another puff stitch in there, so yarn over, go in, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, go in, yarn over, pull through, yarn over and pull through all 5 loops on your hook, and then chain 1. Okay, hop into the next stitch and do the same thing. So puff stitch, then chain 1, then puff stitch back into that same stitch, and then chain 1. Okay, you can see it's coming outward on our piece, so that's going to cover part of the top of our teapot. So just repeat this all the way around, making sure that you have 2 puff stitches in each stitch around, and you have a chain 1 in between every single puff stitch. So I'll meet you up for the next round. Stop. Rewind. Delete this. It's not even funny. When you're finished with this round, you should have 24 of these puff stitches. So 2 in each stitch would make it 24. So now when you're finished, just make sure you chain that last one there to close off that puff stitch. And then we're going to slip stitch to this first stitch, or you can slip stitch into the chain 1 space. Totally up to you where you want to slip stitch. You can either go into this puff stitch right here, or you can go into the chain 1 space between these puff stitches right here. So I'm just gonna go right in there and then yarn over, pull through and through. So now in this next round, in round 4, we are working in the chain 1 spaces. So you may as well just slip stitch into that chain 1 space anyway. And we are going to chain up 1. And in that same chain 1 space, now this whole round is going to be worked in each chain 1 space between each puff stitch, okay? So in this one here, this first one that we just slip stitched into, we're going to put 2 half double crochets in there. So yarn over, go into that chain 1 space, yarn over and pull through, and then yarn over and pull through all 3 loops on your hook, okay? That's a half double crochet. So you have to put 2 of them in the first chain 1 space. So again, yarn over, go back in, yarn over, pull through, and then yarn over and pull through all 3 of those loops. Okay, so there's 2 half double crochets in that first chain 1 space. And then in the next chain 1 space, we're going to put 1 half double crochet. So yarn over, go into this next one, yarn over, pull through, and then yarn over and pull through all 3 loops. Okay, to hopping to the next chain 1 space, we are going to put 2 half double crochets in there. So yarn over, go in to the next chain 1 space, yarn over and pull that through, yarn over and pull through all 3 loops. Okay, and again, yarn over, go back in, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through all 3 loops. Then in the next chain 1 space, we are only putting 1 half double crochet. So this is the pattern, repeat pattern. So this every other chain 1 space is going to get 2 half double crochets. And then every other one after that is going to get 1 half double crochet. If that's confusing, just to put 2 half double crochets in the next chain 1 space, and then 1 half double crochet in the next chain 1 space. And just keep repeating that all the way around. You can follow along with the written pattern, and that will probably explain it a little bit better. But otherwise, I'm just going to continue working this repeat all the way around, and then I'll meet you up for round 5. Alright, you just have to come back around and then slip stitch to the first half double crochet right in here. So go in, then yarn over and pull through and through. Okay, so that's what it should look like so far. Now at this point I am going to go on to round 5 real quick. We're going to chain up 1, and now we're just going to put 1 half double crochet in each stitch around. So you know how to do half double crochets since we just did them all in the last round. So yarn over, go into this first stitch right here that we just slip stitched into, and yarn over and pull through, and then yarn over and pull through all 3 loops. Then hop into the next stitch and half double crochet in there and each stitch around. So while you're doing that, I am going to sew in this end here. So I'm going to pull this up here. While you're crocheting, you can watch how I'm going to sew in this end here in the beginning. We're just going to yarn our needle, We're going to go underneath some of these stitches here. Okay, and just pull it through just like so. Sew it just like so. So just keep pulling it through. Okay, and that's hidden underneath then these stitches. You may need a smaller sewing needle depending on the size of yarn you're using or what type of yarn you're using. But, oh, I lost that one. Silly me. You just have to sew it in under here. Okay, so I'm just gonna sew that in and then stretch it out. Okay, and then you can cut it short to hide the rest. Just like that. So now it's all hidden and nice and looks good. So that's going to go on the top of your teapot right there. Okay, so I'm just going to continue working this round. Round five is just half double crochet in each stitch around. Once I finish here, I'll meet you up for round six. All right, I just came back around. Oops, I went a little extra step there. I'll show you how to slip stitch to the beginning. So you half double crochet around and then go into the first half double crochet here. Yarn over, pull through and through to close that. So now we can go on to round six. You can see here it is starting to kind of bowl because our teapot is kind of round on top. So, and if you stretch it, it kind of flattens out too. So anyway, going on to round six, we are gonna chain up one, and we are going to puff stitch and then chain two in each stitch around. So puff stitch in this very first stitch right here. So yarn over, go into this first stitch, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, go back in to that same stitch, yarn over, pull through, and then yarn over and pull through all five loops on your hook, and then chain two. One and two. Then hop into the next stitch, yarn over, go in, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, go in, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, and pull through all five loops on your hook. If you can. There we go. And then chain two. One and two. And do that all the way around. I forgot to mention rounds four, five, and six will all have 36 stitches. All the way around. So you'll have 36 of these puff stitches for round six. Just chain two after each puff stitch and then puff in each stitch around. So I'm gonna do that and then I'll meet you up for round seven. When you finish your last puff stitch, make sure to chain two and then slip stitch. Like I showed you earlier when we did this puff row, you can slip stitch into the first puff stitch here or go into this chain two space here and slip stitch in there. So yarn over, pull through and through. Now we are working in the chain two spaces anyway, so you may as well slip stitch into the chain two space. And then we're going to chain up two, so yarn over, pull through, one and two. And for round seven now, this chain up two actually counts as a stitch. That is going to count as our first half double crochet. Now we're going to come in, this next round will kind of decrease your rounds to make it kind of cup over, so because now this is as big as the top of our teapot. Okay, so what we're going to do is put one half double crochet in each chain two space. So this one basically has one already because this chain two counts as a stitch. So hop to this next one here, yarn over and go in, yarn over and pull through, and then yarn over and pull through all three loops on your hook. Hop to the next chain two space and half double crochet in there. Okay, and just continue working that all the way around. You will have then 36 of these half double crochets. Okay, you don't even have to chain anything in between them. We're just putting one half double crochet in each chain two space all the way around for a total of 36 half double crochets. And then after this round, we're done working in rounds, we're going to be working in rows next. When you come back around and you half double crochet once in each chain two space, we have to slip stitch to this beginning chain up two right here, one, two. So go into that chain and then yarn over and pull through and pull through. So this is what it should look like. It's kind of bowling up now. Okay, so that's going to cover the top of your teapot very easily. So now we're going to be working in rows. And if you need to mark this point of the video, because we will be coming back to repeat this, I'm not going to show you this twice, because you can easily rewind this to this portion, because we're going to be working this twice. So it'll make sense at the end here, but we're going to go on to now what is called row 8, okay? And we're going to chain up one. And we're going to put a puff stitch into that chain up two stitch that we just slip stitched into. So yarn over, go into that chain up two that we just slip stitched into, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, go back in, yarn over, pull through, and then yarn over and pull through all five loops. Okay, so that first stitch right there. Then we're going to chain one and we're going to puff stitch into the next stitch. Okay, and we're going to do this puff stitch and then chain one in the next, or and then we're going to puff stitch in the next stitch. So then chain one there, and we're going to do this for 18 stitches in total. Okay, that is half of the amount that's around here. So if you are increasing more or less or whatever, just make sure you do half of this piece. So 18 stitches is half of 36 stitches because I have 36 stitches around. So I'm going to make 18 puff stitches with a chain one in between them. Okay, and then once I get to the end here, I will meet you up. We'll go on to row 9. All right, so I have 18 puff stitches. After this last puff stitch, we're going to chain one, but we are only going to turn our work. We're going to leave the rest of these stitches unworked because we're going to come back around and work the other half when I tell you. But we're going to work with this one half first and then the other half after. So we're going to be working in rows now. So we're looking at the inside, or the wrong side of our work here on the inside of our teapot cozy. And we are going to work in these chain one spaces between our puff stitches. And what we're going to do is in each one, we're going to put two half double crochets. So there's 17 of these chain one spaces across. So we will have 34 half double crochets at the end of row 9. So yarn over, go into this first chain one space right here, yarn over, pull through, and then yarn over and pull through all three loops. Okay, and again, yarn over, go back in, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through all three loops. Hop to the next chain one space, yarn over, go in, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through all three loops. Yarn over, go back in, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through all three loops. Okay, so we're just doing this in each one of these chain one spaces. And then at the end of row 9, I'll meet you up. We'll go on to row 10 together. All right, when we're finishing this row, you just have to put two half double crochets in this last space there, just like that. Now we can go on to row 10. So chain up one and turn your work. So now we are looking at the outside of our work. Now rows 10, 12, 11, 12, and 13. So the next four rows are just putting one half double crochet into each stitch, which is 34 stitches, okay, across. So one half double crochet in each stitch across, and then chain one and turn your work. So for round 11, you'll be looking at the inside of your teapot cozy, working across the row. Row 12, you'll be looking at the outside, and row 13, you'll look at the inside. When I'm finished row 13, I will meet you up and we'll go on to row 14. We're gonna decrease. Now, if your teapot is taller than mine, then you can continue working these rows. It's just one half double crochet in each stitch across, chain one, turn your work, and half double crochet across. So very simple. If you need it to be taller, you can do so. But once I finish row 13, because I only have to do four rows to cover my teapot, then I'll meet you up and we'll start decreasing the bottom. So I'll meet you up for row 14. All right, I just finished row 13, so this is kind of what it looks like on the inside here. Now we're going to go on to row 14, just chain up one and turn your work. And now what we have to do is half double crochet two together. So yarn over, go into this first stitch here, yarn over and pull through, and then go directly into the next stitch right here, yarn over and pull that, then pull that through. So now we have four loops on the hook. We're going to yarn over and pull through all four of the loops. Okay, and that is a half double crochet decrease or a half double crochet two together. Now we're going to half double crochet into each stitch across until the last two stitches, and we're going to decrease those two together. So I'm just going to put one half double crochet in the rest of these stitches until I have two stitches left, and then I'll meet you up and we'll go on to the next step together. Okay, coming up on the end of row 14 here, you have two stitches left. We're going to decrease those. So yarn over, go into the first one, yarn over, pull through, go directly into the next one, the last stitch on this row, and then yarn over and pull through, and then yarn over and pull through all four loops on your hook. Okay, and that was row 14. You should have 32 stitches now across. You can see here that it is bowling up like this. Looks good, shiny. Now going on to row 15 here, we're gonna chain one and turn our work. And row 15 is exactly the same as row 14. So we're going to decrease these first two stitches together. So yarn over, go into the first stitch, yarn over, pull through, go into the next stitch, yarn over, pull through, and then yarn over and pull through all four loops. Okay, and then half double crochet into each stitch all the way across until you get to the last two stitches, and we're going to decrease those together. So I'll meet you up at the end of this row, and then we will go right on to row 16. All right, finishing row 15, I have these two stitches left, so I'm going to decrease them. So yarn over, go into this first one, yarn over, pull through, go into the last stitch on this row, and then yarn over and pull through, and then yarn over and pull through all four loops on your hook. And now we can go on to row 16. So chain one and turn your work. Now, this decrease, actually, at the end of row 15, you should have 30 stitches, okay? And now going on to row 16, we are actually going to decrease six times on this row. So what we're going to do is decrease these first two stitches together. So yarn over, go into the first stitch, yarn over, pull through, then go into the next stitch, yarn over, pull through, and then yarn over and pull through all four loops. And now we're going to put a regular half double crochet into the next three stitches. So yarn over, go into this next stitch, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through all three loops. Okay, one, two, and three. And then we're going to repeat what we did. So half double crochet two together. So yarn over, go into this next one, yarn over, pull through, go into the next stitch, yarn over, pull through, and then yarn over and pull through all four loops. Okay, and then half double crochet, a regular half double crochet in the next three stitches. So one, two, and three. Okay, now I'm going to continue working that repeat. So half double crochet two together, and then half double crochet into the next three stitches. At the end of row 16, you'll have 24 half double crochet stitches across. So I will just repeat this, and then I'll meet you up for row 17. Alright, just finishing this round here, we just have to half double crochet in the last three stitches. And then, going on to row 17, we are going to decrease again. So chain up one, turn your work around, okay? You can see that it is making that really curved shape here for the side of the teapot. Looks really cool. So now, we are going to half double crochet two together. So yarn over, go into this first one, yarn over, pull through, go into the next stitch, yarn over, pull through, and then yarn over and pull through all four loops. And now we're only going to put one half double crochet into the next two stitches this time. So next stitch here and the next stitch here. And then we're going to decrease again and repeat that across. So half double crochet two together, just like this, and then half double crochet into the next two stitches. Okay, And we're doing that all the way across. So half double crochet two together, and then half double crochet in the next two stitches. So at the end of this row, you'll have 18 stitches. So I'll meet you up and we will go on to row 18. All right, just finished row 17, so now I'm just gonna chain one and turn my work. So I have 18 stitches across here. You can see the shape of it is really coming together. So now we're just going to do a half double crochet row. So we're just putting one half double crochet into each one of these 18 stitches across. This is row 18. And then at the end of this row, I'm going to fasten off and then we'll go on to the next step together. When you finish row 18, if you need to, you can go on to making more rows if your teapot is a little bit taller, but mine is going to fit in here, so I'm going to fasten off. So just chain one, and we're going to cut our yarn longer because we're going to be sewing this. So just continue to pull this all the way through like that and then pull that tight. And then we'll use this strand to sew it later. But you can grab your teapot and kind of see how it's going to fit around it, kind of like this. Okay, so it's going to hug it really nicely on this side. Okay, so now we have to, and then we're going to it's on backwards, sorry. We're gonna sew it in the front and the button is gonna go in the back. So this is where, right here is where we're going to sew it closed to the other side. So we have to make this other side. So what I need you to do, when I said earlier to mark this part where we were working in rows, row eight, first off, we're going to attach our yarn. Okay, we're gonna look at the outside of our work here. Okay, you're gonna start right here in this next free stitch right next to this row here, or right next to the stitch that's worked in last. So we're gonna start right here, and we're going to hook on our yarn, okay? And then you're going to chain one, and repeat exactly what we did for rows 8 through 18. On this side, okay? So just rewind this video to see exactly what I did. We're just gonna make this thing exactly the same as the other side. So I'm gonna finish this part off camera because it is an exact repeat. And then I will meet you up at the end of this little section here when I finish row 18, and we'll go on to the next step together. All right, so I finished the repeat of row 8 through 18 here for the second side, but before you fasten this off, we are going to finish off by making a loop because we are on this opposite side. We are going to sew a button on here so a loop can fit around the button. So what we're going to do for that is chain an amount, I guess, however, depending on how big the button you are using is. I'm going to chain 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, and then we're going to come down to about here, right at, you can see there's a half double crochet stitch right here, right where that's worked into. We're going to go in, and then yarn over, and pull through, okay, and there's your loop for the buttonhole. Now to fasten this part off, we're just going to chain one and cut your yarn. You can cut it short and pull that through and pull it tight. Okay, and then we're going to weave in this end here. So I'm just going to yarn my needle. Let me get my other needle because this one's kind of big. So yarn your needle, just like that, and then go underneath these stitches. Okay, and sew in that little straggler that we just cut. Okay, and then cut any extra yarn, and there's your little buttonhole. Now on this side, since this is the front of the piece here, you can see this is the top, okay? Our spout is gonna come out here, so we have to sew this bottom part closed. So if you want to, grab your teapot here, put it on your teapot, okay, and then you can see in the front here how it's going to look wrapped around. You can kind of like mark it where you want to kind of seam it up here. So I want to seam from here down, okay? Or I guess we're going to work up since our straggler here is that long straggler. We're going to seam it up to about halfway. So I'm going to now remove this and set this aside. Grab my yarn needle, okay? Yarn the needle. Okay, and then we're going to just whip stitch this. So we're just going to go in one side, out the other side. Okay, and we're going to go up this piece here. So just where the needle fits, where you feel most comfortable sewing it, just go around and around. Okay, there are different ways. You could slip stitch this closed, you could mattress stitch it closed. Crochet it, you know, single crochet it closed. Just to close this little section here so that there's no opening and it will fit around the spout. Also, be sure that it is lined up rows by rows. Okay. So it's not lopsided or weird. Okay, and I'm just gonna go about halfway up here. Depending on where your spout is and how big of a spout you have on your teapot cozy, you're going to have to go a little higher or a little lower. So it depends on where that spout is, I guess. Okay, so then when you are about to fasten this off, I feel like this is a good spot to stop. We're going to go in, we're going to keep that loop up, and we're going to go back into that loop. Okay, and then tie it off. So tie it tight. And then you can do one or two knots in there, and then we're going to sew this end in underneath the stitches that we just worked. Okay, and you can go back and forth just like that. Okay, stretch it out, cut any extra, and there it is. So that's going to be where your spout is going to go. So you can grab your piece here. Okay, put it into there on the top. Situate it how it's supposed to look. All right, so the last thing we have to do here for this piece before we embellish is tie a button on this bottom part right here so that this loop can fit right there so that it is secure. Okay, so what I'm going to do is take this off again, grab a button, I'm going to position it right there, and grab a piece of yarn to sew it on. Okay, so we're going to grab some yarn, grab our yarn needle. Yarn our needle again. There's quite a bit of sewing at this point now. Okay, so position this little button. I'm just using a simple plastic button here. You can use a vintage button or any type of cute little button that you may have. And, oh man, I gotta pull this all the way through here. There we go. Okay, and then go back in. There. Okay, then we're going to tie that into a knot on the other side. Okay, you can tie it twice or three times. And then we're going to take those strands and sew them in underneath the stitches to hide that. So you can go back and forth like this. Oops. Okay. And then once you're all finished, you know, you could just be done with this, just have a nice plain design, plain cup cozy, Or cup cozy. Teapot cozy. I was thinking about the cup cozy I made the other day. Check out that video, you guys. But here you can have just a nice plain design here for your teapot cozy. You can button that. There. Oh, lovely. And it hugs it really nicely underneath. Looks really good. Okay, that is so cool. So now you have a nice teapot cozy, but at this point, like I said, you can be done and have just a nice plain teapot cozy and enjoy your pot of tea. But at this point, I want to embellish. So you can embellish with different appliques or embroider stuff or whatever you want to make. But I'll come back and I will show you what we are going to make on the outside of our teapot cozy. All right, welcome back. So I made all of these embellishments off camera. Don't worry, I'm going to show you how to make each and every single thing, and then we're going to, you can see this jumbled mess of yarn, we're going to sew these all to our teapot. So I am going to show you how to make the leaf, how to make a berry, and then how to make the lettering, making chains, and then we're going to sew them onto our piece. So I'm using the word joy, you can see here, but you can use any word you want. You can make the word tea if you wanted to and have a like nice little teapot. You don't have to have these embellishments in these specific spots. You can omit the completely the embellishments. You can omit them, or you can just do one or both, or put them somewhere else around here. I'm also going to do the back side. I want to center this a little bit more, so put it on this closer to the center here. But you can see here we're putting this on the back side. But again, you don't have to do this. This is just a creator's choice, and this is exactly how mine is going to look. So I made these little embellishments. I pinned them down using sewing needles, and then we're going to sew them on around this piece. So what I'm going to do is just set this aside right now. I'm going to show you how to make a leaf first, a holly leaf. I'm going to demonstrate with this Red Heart Super Saver yarn just because it is going to be a little difficult to use the Gleam yarn in patina. So but you can use this Gleam yarn, you can use any yarn. I'm just going to show you using this green yarn that's Red Heart Super Saver. Because you're not going to need a whole lot. This doesn't take a whole lot. But I'm using, let's see here, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 of those leaves. So you can make as many as you want, but I'm making 7 of these. So let's start out with a slip knot. So put your short end over your long end, then fold that down and pull that through and pull it tight. Then insert your hook in that loop, pull that tight. And now we are going to chain 9. So yarn over and pull through 1. Yarn over and pull through 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. Now for round 1 of this leaf, we are going to slip stitch in the second chain from the hook. So the loop on the hook doesn't count as anything, so count 1 and 2. And you can see the chain like this. I like to actually turn my chain toward me and work in these back ridges of the chain, just because it'll be easier to work on the opposite end because we're going to be coming back around and working on the opposite end of our foundation. So we're going to slip stitch in the second chain, so 1, 2, right in here, go in, and then yarn over and pull through and pull through. In the next chain, we're going to single crochet. So go in, yarn over, pull through, and then yarn over and pull through 2 loops. In the next 4 chains, we're going to half double crochet in each one of those. So yarn over, go into this next chain, yarn over, pull through, and then yarn over and pull through all 3 loops. Okay, yarn over, go into the next chain, yarn over, pull through all 3 loops. And the next chain, half double crochet, and this next chain, half double crochet. Then we're going to single crochet into the next chain, so go in, yarn over, pull through, and then yarn over and pull through 2 loops. In this last chain, we're going to slip stitch. So go in there, yarn over, pull through and through, and then chain two, one and two, and then slip stitch back into that same space, that same chain there. Go in, yarn over, pull through and through. Now you can see I turned this around upside down because we're going to be working on this opposite end of our chain here. So what we're going to do is go into this stitch right here, okay? So not this stitch right here because our slip stitch is worked into that first one there. So going into this next one right here, we're going to single crochet. So go in, yarn over and pull through, and then yarn over and pull through two loops. Okay, then we're going to half double crochet in the next four stitches here, yarn over, go into this next one, yarn over, pull through, then yarn over and pull through all three loops. So that's one, next one is two, next one is three, and the next one is four. Then we're going to single crochet into the next stitch. So go in, yarn over, pull through, yarn over and pull through two loops. And we're going to slip stitch into this last one here. So go in, yarn over, pull through, and pull through. Now what we're going to do, you can kind of pull this up just a tad, not too much. We're going to slip stitch into this first stitch right here. This will be our first slip stitch of this round. So we're just going to go on to round two right now, just slip stitch into this first stitch, yarn over, pull through, and through. And then we're going to slip stitch into this next stitch right here. So go in, yarn over, pull through, and through. Now we're going to make something called a picot. So we are going to chain two, one and two, and then slip stitch to the second chain from the hook. So again, the loop on the hook doesn't count, so count one and two in this second chain. We're going to go into there, and then yarn over and pull through and through. And then we're going to slip stitch into the next two stitches. So go into this next stitch right here, slip stitch in there, and this next stitch right here. Go in, yarn over, pull through, and through. Then we're going to make another picot. So chain two, one, two, and slip stitch in that second chain from the hook. Pull through and through, just like that. And then slip stitch into the next two stitches. So slip stitch, and the next stitch, slip stitch. Then we're going to do that again. So chain up two, slip stitch in the second chain from the hook to make our picot. And then slip stitch now into these next two stitches and into the chain two space here. So go into this next stitch, into this next stitch, and then into this picot. So go into, or not picot, sorry, this chain two space here at the tip of our leaf. Go into there, yarn over, pull through and through. Now chain two, one, two, and we're not going to slip stitch in the second chain from the hook. We're just going to go back into that chain two space down here and slip stitch in there. So yarn over, pull through and through. Now we are going to skip this slip stitch here and slip stitch into the single crochet right here. So go in, yarn over, pull through and through, and slip stitch into this half double crochet right here. So go in, yarn over, pull through and through. Now we're going to picot, so chain two, slip stitch in the second chain from the hook, yarn over, pull through and through, slip stitch into the next two stitches, one and two, then picot again, so chain two, slip stitch into the second chain from the hook, then slip stitch into the next two stitches, and then picot again, so chain two, slip stitch into the second chain from the hook. And now right here we're going to slip stitch into this stitch right here. Okay, it's going to be kind of tough. It's been tough for me to make all these leaves here. Go in, yarn over, pull through and through. And then our last slip stitch is going to go right into this stitch right here. This is a slip stitch as well. Go in, yarn over, pull through and through. And now we can fasten off. So chain one, you're going to cut your yarn quite long because we will be using that for sewing. Okay, so cut it long. There we go. And then continue to pull that all the way through, and then pull that tight. Now grab your yarn needle, and in the back here, we are going to sew in this short end here from our slip knot. When we made our slip knot, we have this little straggler. So we're going to take our yarn needle, sew this in underneath the stitches. Okay, just a few stitches, just like that. Stretch it out, cut that yarn, and there you have a cute little holly leaf. So there's the leaf that we are going to make. So I'll make 6 more of these. If you want to, you can make more or less, doesn't matter. However many of these you want to put on your teapot cozy, you can totally make as many of these as you want. Now I need to make the berry to embellish with the holly leaves. So I'm gonna set this aside. I'm gonna grab that red yarn and we are going to make the berry next. All right, so I grabbed my red heart shimmer in red here, and I'm going to make a slip knot. So put your short end over your long end, fold that down, and then pull that through and pull tight. Okay, insert your hook. And for the berry, it's actually very simple. We are going to chain 2, so yarn over, pull through, 1 and 2. And then in the second chain from the hook, we are going to put 6 single crochets. So the loop on the hook doesn't count, so count 1 and 2 right in that second chain. We're going to go in, yarn over, pull through, and then yarn over and pull through 2 loops. Okay, that's a single crochet. So we're going to make 6 of those in that same chain. So that was 1, go back into it, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through 2. That's 2. This is 3. Here's 4, 5, and 6. But instead of slip stitching to this first single crochet right here, which is what I usually do, I slip stitch to that and then fasten off, I actually found out this new cool thing to do. So we're gonna pause here. We're gonna cut our yarn long for sewing, and we're going to continue to pull it through that stitch. Okay, then we're gonna grab our yarn needle and that long strand that we just cut, and we're going to yarn our needle with that strand. Then what we're going to do is count back 6 here. So this is our last stitch we made. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. In this first stitch right here, we're going to go into it. Okay, you can go either from the front of it or through the back of it. It does not matter at all. So I'm just going to go through this front here, just like this, going all the way through. Okay, and then you can see our last stitch we made right there. We're going to go into the top of it along with this loop back here. So you can see those 2 loops there. We're going to go into there just like that. And that just makes an invisible stitch, kind of an invisible join. I know you may have heard that term before, and it makes it look like there's an extra stitch right there. So we just created that working with this straggler. So now you can sew this on, but oh, there's a big gaping hole there too. If you started the way I did, you're probably gonna have a hole. If you started with a magic ring, you won't have a hole. So what we're gonna do now is take the yarn off the needle and put the yarn that is the short straggler from our slip knot, put that on the needle. Okay, so yarn your needle with that, and then we're going to just weave that in underneath these stitches in the back. And that way you can pull it tight and it will close that hole in the middle of this red little circle here. See? Just like that. You can go all the way around. Okay, but if you made the magic ring, you probably won't have this problem. So that's just me. So there's a little berry. So now, let's see, how many did I make of this? Three, six, nine. So I made nine of these, but again, you can make as many of these as you want. Once you make your leaves and your berries, I can show you how to sew them onto your teapot cozy. All right, once you have your leaves and your berries all made, you can, if you want to, position them, pin them down, kind of see where you want to keep them. That's optional, but I just wanted to pin it down just to get a little idea of where I wanted to put mine. So now we can sew them on. So I'm basically just taking them off. Okay. And to sew these on, it's actually not that difficult here. We're going to sew on the leaves first, and then we're going to sew on the berries. So I want this in the center back here. Okay. And we have the long strand. We're going to grab our yarn needle here. Let me grab it. Get my area all cleared out. Okay. So, I showed you how to make this leaf with the Red Heart Super Saver yarn, but I made all of my leaves in the Gleam yarn in Patina. So, you can see that here. So, I wanted this one in the center, like this. And we're just going to pin it down basically. So, going underneath into the cup co or into the cozy itself, and then out into the leaf. Okay. And then just going in and out. Just like that. Okay? You don't have to even pin down the holly leaf, these picots. You can just pin down just the leaf part. But if you want to, just go back and forth in and out of this piece. And make sure you're going through the layer of the I keep saying cup cozy, the teapot cozy also. When you're ready to fasten off, okay, we are going to go into the teapot cozy into a few stitches and then out the bottom here. And you want to end yours on the bottom of a leaf. Okay, so this is the top, this is the bottom. So you want to end down here. And we're going to come around. We're going to keep our finger in this loop here. Okay. And then we're going to come back around into that loop and then pull tight to tie our knot. Okay. And you can do that once, twice, or three times. I'm just going to do it once because this is just a teapot cozy. It's not going to see many rough days. So it's pretty secure. So I'm just going to sew this in underneath these stitches now. Okay, pull that tight. Cut any extra, stretch it out, make sure it's all hidden. So there's one leaf. Grabbing the other leaf on this side here. We're gonna do the same exact thing for all the leaves. Now you can see the ones on the front here. Don't worry, I'll still show you how to make this joy here. But you can see on the front here that they are coming off the top, okay, of the cup cozy. So you can see we just sewed the bottom half of that. So they're kind of just hanging there. So that's for the leaves on the front. But the leaves on the back, I have it pinned down, I guess most of it. This part is kind of coming off. So, like half of it. You can just, tack it down. Like I said, though, these are not going to be, being used roughly or how kids are with hats and scarves, and then those are like really need to be sewn together. But this is just a simple design here. So, we're just going to tack these down. Okay, so I guess I'll just tack these leaves down, and then once I have the leaves down, we'll sew on the berries, and then I'll show you how to make the joy or the word in the front of our teapot cozy. All right, so I sewed on all these leaves here. I even sewed on some of the berries and these leaves already. So you can see here. Now I want to show you how to sew on the berries, and then we'll go on to making this word here. So the berries are actually not so difficult, but kind of difficult. So let me show you how to do that. So you want to take your little circle here, the little red circle here. And then on the short end, we're going to actually, since you sewed that in, we're going to snip it. So cut that off. Just like that. So now we have just the one end, the long end to sew. So we are going to yarn our needle with that long straggler. And then we're going to position this where we want it to go. So right in the middle is good for me. And then we're going to go in to the teapot cozy. Okay, but now this part is the where the difficult part is, because I am sewing this on it as it's on the teapot. So what I'm going to try and do is try to stretch this so I can get that needle, that yarn needle, through. At this point, if you wanted to, you could sew these pieces on off the teapot cozy, but I just wanted it to be stretched out so when I did put it on, it wasn't going to be stretched out a whole lot. I hope that makes sense to you, but here, let me unbutton this here, and you can see that the fabric kind of squishes in, okay, and so it's not as stretched, so we want it to be stretched so that it doesn't look weird and wonky later. So let me pull this needle through. I just pulled it all the way through, okay, and that's where the berry is going to go, right there, okay. Then we're going to go back through the back here and out the berry. Okay. And we want to end on the inside. So we're going to go back in to the teapot cozy. Okay. But at this point, since I only have one berry down, I'm just going to undo my yarn from that needle and leave that on the inside. And when I have all my berries on here, I'm going to fasten these all off together. So I'll show you again. We have another berry here. Let me get this all situated. Okay, so yarn that needle just like that. Put it where you want it to go. Right here is good. Going into the cup cozy, or I keep saying cup cozy, you guys, I'm so sorry. The teapot cozy. Going in and then coming back out. Okay. And then going back in. Okay. And again, I'm gonna take that yarn off of there. And I'll fasten that off when I have my last one on. So I just want to get my third one on here. So position that. Go in. And I'm just doing three stitches. So going in, then out, and then in. Okay, and that's all I'm doing for the berries. So you can do more if you want to get it more secure, but that's creator's choice. All right. So now all the berries are on. Looks fabulous. So now we're going to put this inside out so you can see all of our straggly ends here of these three. So what we're going to do is tie them in a knot. Let's take two in one hand, one in the other hand, and tie them in a knot. Okay, then you can take those stragglers and just like I've shown you before, this is gonna tip over here, we're gonna sew in these ends. So I have my massive yarn needle. And we're just going to go underneath some stitches. Okay. It doesn't have to be perfect. Nobody's going to see this side of your work. Okay. And then just trim that short. And there it is. Lovely. Okay. So now we just have to do the same thing for these berries on this side and these berries on this side. You can see I've already started and I just have to tie those. I have to put one more berry on this side and then tie those. And then I put all three of these berries, but you can see my stragglers are right here. So I have to tie those off. And then once I have my holly and berries all sewn on, I'll show you how to make this word joy. And then we'll be done with our teapot cozy. Alright, so I sewed on all of my holly and berries and fastened everything off, so now it looks fabulous, but not so fabulous yet. We have to sew this on here. So I was going to show you how to make these. It's basically just chaining, but I'll show you anyway. For those of you who are unsure, grab some of that red shimmer yarn and your crochet hook. And for the words, now you could embroider this. You could totally just sew this in, you know, embroidering and make a word yourself. You don't have to have a word, or if you wanted to have, you know, a different word, you can totally do that. It's so simple. We are just chaining an amount to make it look good, basically. So what we're gonna do is make a slip knot, just like how I've shown you in this video already. And we are just going to chain a crazy amount. So yarn over and pull through, and just keep yarning over and pulling through, okay? This is actually good practice too for your chaining method. Just yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through. I know you guys say that I say it too much every single day, but I'm gonna say it even more, yarn over, pull through. So we just wanna do that as many as you need to. And then we're gonna pull this up a little bit, okay? And then we're going to take this, and I'll show you exactly what I did here. For this J, I'll just show you right above it. I just put this down on the piece, and then I just pinned it down. And I stopped here, and see how many chains I have extra? I just unraveled that part. Okay, right there. Then what I did, once it was pinned down and everything, I cut my yarn long, okay, and then I took that loop and pulled that long strand through, okay, and that is how I did that. So now I'm going to take that long strand and this short strand and sew this on to my cup cozy, cup cozy again, my teapot cozy. So that is how you have to do that. So just do that for each piece. So I did this straight piece across, then I did this as a new piece, this curve of the J. The O is one full chain, one straight chain, just like that. And then the Y is two chains. It's this one chain right here, this from here down, and then this loop here, and then this part right here, okay? And I just had my my teapot cozy on the teapot, and then I'm pinning this down. You do not want to pin down the chains of your word when it is off of your teapot, because when you put this on the teapot, it is going to stretch out and look interesting, to say, for lack of a better word. So it's gonna look different. So you want to have it on your teapot cozy, pin it down if you can, and then just sew it on. So what I'm going to do is take the long strand, and just like I showed you for the holly and berries, we're just gonna yarn our needle, okay? We're going to go, you can unpin as you go, okay? And we're gonna go into the teapot cozy and out one of the chains, okay? Then into the teapot cozy, and then out the next chain, okay? And I'm removing the pins as I go, and make it just look good. You know, this part is going to get quite tedious, but it is so worth it in the end. So I'm going to take my time and make sure that each part is sewn on. Once you're finished with a section, you're going to pull this all the way through into the back of your teapot cozy, so it is all hidden and clean here. And then when we're all done sewing everything in, we're going to, like we did for the berries, we're going to flip this inside out and then tie everything off. So I'm just going to sew these on with my long strands here. Just yarn your needle and then just remove your pins as you go. Okay, and just go into the teapot cozy and out one of the chains. And that's how I'm making mine. That's exactly what I'm doing here. I'm doing it on camera for you right now. This is never before done. I've never made a teapot cozy with the word joy on it before, other than right now. So you're seeing firsthand what I'm doing step by step. So this is how I'm making mine, but you can obviously do it differently if you need to, you know, embroider it and not do these chains, or if you wanted to make your word in cursive, you don't have to make it, you know, exactly the same as me. So get creative with it, you know, but I'm just going to sew this on all of my pieces. So like I said, this top part was one piece. This part is another piece. This is another piece, this is another piece, and this is another piece. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 pieces in total for the word joy. Now, if you're making a different word, obviously you're going to have different amounts of chains. Just make it look good. It's really eyeballing it, really tedious, but I'm just going to go slow with this and make it to my liking. And then once I have this all done, I'll meet you back up. I'll show you when I get to the fastening off part and sewing all those ends on the inside in. I'll show you how to do that so that you can hide your ends and make it look good. So I'll meet you up when all of these are all sewn on and we'll fasten this off together. All right, much better. Less loose ends to have to deal with. So the joy word is on there. Looks fabulous, but I still have to sew in those ends. So what I'm going to do now is take this off here. Okay, take it all off of the teapot. And on the inside, you can see the ends are need to be all hidden and sewn in. So what I'm going to do to secure everything is tie these all in knots. Okay, so I'm just tying them all in knots just like that. And then I'm going to sew them in underneath the stitches. So I'm gonna grab my handy dandy yarn needle. But now this part is kind of tricky because you want to sew them in underneath the stitches, but you don't want them to be seen on the other side. So we're going to go in the back of these stitches. Okay. And you don't even have to sew in a whole lot. We're just going to go underneath a few of these loops. Okay. And then go back through. And you can even go back once more if you wanted to. Totally up to you. Just sew in that end just like that. Both of those ends are sewn in. And once you're comfortable with it being sewn in, you can chop that and then go on to the next. So I have a few ends I gotta sew in, but I'm gonna do it exactly like I just showed you for each one. Just tying them in a knot and then going underneath some of the loops in the back here so that you won't be able to see it. If you flip it over, you will not see that being sewn in on the opposite side. So that is what we have to do so that it is not seen. So I'm just gonna go underneath the back loops here. Oops, I lost my yarn. I'm just gonna do that for all of the loose ends on the side, and then I'll bring my teapot back in here and we will cover it and enjoy this beautiful teapot cozy. All right, just finishing here. Just gonna put it on my teapot now. I just weaved in all of my ends and everything is looking so fabulous. I'm so excited about this. So, I just want to say a big, huge thank you for watching and learning how to make this beautiful teapot cozy today with me. This looks so wonderful. So, thanks so much. Make sure if you make this, I would love to see what your teapot cozy looks like. So share a photo on the Facebook, on the Instagram, hashtag Yarn Utopia. You can also hashtag joy, hashtag joy, hashtag the joyful teapot cozy, all that good stuff. Also, you can Snapchat me. I'd like to see a few second snap of what you make today on your crochet hook. So, thanks so much for watching. Thanks to my dad for videotaping this also, so you guys can see me make this. Until next time, happy hooking!